This is Bloomberg UTV.
It's a fast-moving sector in more ways than one. And for companies in the space, new launches, product innovations, and turning consumer insights into quick marketing campaigns are all part of a day's work, made even more exciting because of the sheer diversity of the Indian marketplace. So to understand what's brewing in the FMCG and the packaged food space, I caught up with Britannia head Vinita Bali, who not only has her hands full dealing with competition and the complex market dynamics on the ground, she's also looking ahead, taking her company's focus on the health and nutrition space into a totally new level. Vinita, welcome on Second Wave. Thank you for joining me today. You know, I want to start with a quote that you used in one of your interviews where you said that in a slowdown, you have to run faster and be one step ahead of competition. Are you still running as fast, or has a slowdown kind of slowed down?
Oh, no, there is no slowdown. I think the nature of the business and the market demands that we continue to learn how to run faster and faster, because with the number of choices available to consumers and everything else that is competing for their attention, to stay ahead of the game, you've really got to run fast and have the ability to keep that momentum and speed.
But are things looking better on the ground? If you were to compare it to last year this time, what are your own learnings about the way consumers have changed?
You know, what we are seeing is a couple of things which are sort of general statements. I think people in India, or consumers in India, are really smart. They don't evaluate necessarily how much they are paying for something, but how much that product is worth it to them. I think we are seeing across the board in every category, whether you think of television sets or cell phones or biscuits or anything else, there are more and more choices available at rates which are quite competitive. So the consumer is looking back and saying, how best do I allocate the disposable income that I have across categories and then across brands within the category? So today, I don't think consumers are choosing between this biscuit versus that biscuit. Instead, consumers are choosing between, you know, biscuits and bhujia. Consumers are choosing between, you know, going to a film or, you know, going and enjoying a cup of coffee.
I know there are multiple choices. There are multiple people trying to vie for your money and every rupee. But the two things that you keep hearing about, Vinita, is one, that disposable income is high, especially in the middle to lower middle class segment. And second, that every rural India is where the growth is. Are your sales figures also indicating that disposable income is high and rural India is where the returns are coming from?
You know, I want to correct that disposable income is high. Yes, we are seeing a growth in disposable income, but that rate of growth has actually slowed down. And I think the logic is really very simple. We are talking about an India that was growing GDP between 8.5% to 9% every year. We're now talking about an India where GDP growth is estimated anywhere between 5.5% to 6.5%. Now, that has a direct bearing on the amount of money that is available to people to spend. The fact is, you just have to step out and go and check out the prices of commodities. Rice is more expensive today than it was last year. Wheat is more expensive today than it was last year. Sugar is, vegetables are, dals are, etc., etc. If you look at the average Indian consumer, a large proportion of our disposable income is spent on food. And when the staples are becoming as expensive as they are, at every step, the consumer is actually recalibrating. So we are seeing growth, but the kind of rates of growth we saw, for example, in the last 4 years, that rate of growth has actually slowed down. We're talking about a market which is growing anywhere between 11 to 12%, compared with that same market that was growing between 17 and 18%. So there is growth, but the rate of growth is lower than it has been in the last 4 years.
In fact, that's quite reflective in the Britannia numbers also, from the heady double-digit kind of sales growth over the last 12 quarters. I mean, there was a sharp correction. Do you think that trend is going to stay, and that is going to be a challenge considering that you also have raw material costs going up?
Well, let's look at it this way. We've had a four-year compound annual growth of 22%. Now, I think it's hard, even though, as I said earlier, we're running fast. It's hard to keep running at that 22% rate of growth. So, yes, you're right, in the last two quarters, that rate of growth has slowed down. But we're definitely going to see growth in the coming quarters. I think one of our other challenges really has been in terms of managing to retain the operating margins that we've got in the business in the face of, again, pretty significant and concurrent increase in the price of commodities. In fact, in the last 4 years that I've been in this business, we've been looking at commodity pricing and saying, you know, maybe that this is the last year of a humongous inflation, but it never seems to be the last year. You know, right now it's sugar, it's also wheat. Now, all of that poses a challenge, which we're attacking in terms of looking very, very hard at costs and also looking at what we call revenue management or how we manage our mix.
You know, inflation is, I'm glad you brought that up because that's turning out to be the biggest fear, because that's the other side of growth and any kind of revival that you're going to be seeing, because right now it's supply side, it could soon become demand side. Do you think we've done enough? Has the world done enough about inflation? Because what happened last year in July, August seems to be almost on the verge of repeating itself.
Yeah, you know, the other thing I would say is when we talk about India, we talk about India as some homogeneous mass, and it isn't. We're looking at a very heterogeneous population with very heterogeneous demographics. And therefore, at a certain level, you know, this rate of inflation actually means that people are cutting down on what they're consuming, you know, as we said earlier. And if you look at some other indices of, consumption of food or, what is called the Human Development Index, which takes into account a multiplicity of factors, the sad story is that we've not improved in those areas. Our situation has become worse than it actually was. So on the one hand, there is great economic development. But on the other hand, the average level of consumption in this country has not really increased. So at the margin, we are pushing. But, has that gain been shared equally by everybody? The truthful answer is no.
Well, we'll talk about that at length, Vinita. But after this short break, I want to talk to you about what strategies have worked in this period.
Sure.
Because like the shampoo space, I think the biscuit space has also gone small and mobile. So we'll come back with that. Stay tuned.